Earlier, I talked about planning, right? And planning for a meal. This is where MRP really gets into the planning aspect, material requirements planning. What material are required for you to plan your product is the question that MRP asks. So we're going to look at in this video the differences between MRP, MRP II, and ERP. So first, MRP is material requirements planning, and it's really about getting the right amount of material at the right place at the right time to support production and the things that you are producing. It includes three important things: the master schedule file, right? Bill of material, which is just a list of the material, and inventory files, where are your inventory levels. So again, MRP is really a simple system for you. Well, I don't want to say it's simple, but it's a system in which you can plan for production. Remember, this is about your raw material. This is not the master production schedule producing your finished good. This is about everything that goes into those finished goods products. You have to plan for the raw material, right? On one side, then you have to produce that product once you receive all of your raw material. So the one difference I could say between MRP, MRP2, and ERP is the level of bandwidth that these programs can handle. These are just software systems, right, that manage data. The more data you need managed, the bigger the system you have to be. Consider MRP level 1, MRP 2 level 2, and ERP being level 3. Now, there are other systems out there, but for the sake of this course, we're only talking about these three. So when we graduate from MRP to MRP 2, MRP 2 is actually manufacturing resource planning, right? So there are other aspects of planning that goes into MRP 2. When we look at MRP, this is all about getting our material. Can we track it in the system? Do we know when we'll receive it, right? But when things get a little bit more complex and we want to add forecasting into the mix, or we want to add some marketing and sales into the mix, then we have to graduate from that MRP to that MRP2 system. So when we look at production planning, demand and forecasting analysis, we can't do that in an MRP system. We have to go to an MRP2 system. Again, manufacturing resource planning. We're looking at production. And because we're looking at production, we need a more robust system that can do more than just track inventory for us, right? Now, when do we actually go to an ERP system? Enterprise Resource Planning System. An ERP system is used by most of the bigger companies today because it's just best to have one place to go to where everyone in the organization can access data. And that's the key thing, is accessibility. When everyone in the organization needs to use the same system to access data, especially when you have a ton of customers and you have a customer ID, I'm in Georgia, I can look at your data by typing in your customer ID, and the CEO of the company, well, better yet, I'm the CEO of the company. Someone else in the company is in California, and they're typing in your ID, and they can see the same information. Enterprise resource planning. Now, you can do some of that stuff in an MRP, MRP2 system, but the key with the ERP system is managing more data. When you have so much data you have to track, and think this builds, is more than just the production planning and the material requirements planning. Human resources and managing employee data, maybe even student data, a ton more information goes into an enterprise system. So, key takeaways. If you're just trying to produce a product, track your material, receive your material on time, an MRP system will do the job. When you bring in production planning and forecasting, it's time to upgrade from that MRP to that MRP2 system. And then if you need even more aspects of your organization all in one place, key takeaway, everyone in your organization needs to access the data. You want to graduate to an ERP or Enterprise Resource Planning System.